Welcome to the workout. Let's make sure you can see it. Okay, we're gonna start pigeon. So the easiest way to start this is on all fours. And then you will slide one knee forward, slide the other knee back, stretching out into this hip. Straight on. So this foot is in front of this other thigh over here. Hands are on the ground. And I like to flip up or like drop down to the side and then push back up, drop down to the side. So you're kind of rocking into it, that hip. Nice. Let's go other side. Bring the knee up, bring the other leg back. The foot again goes into the front of the other thigh. And let your hip kind of shoot down towards the ground and come up. If your hip doesn't go there easily, just hang out in that top position. But if you like the extra little stretch, go ahead and push into it. Great, going into windshield wipers. So we are on our backs like this. Knees are up, about a 90 degree angle or a little more. Anything in this range, just don't drop the feet way down. Engage the core, so you're pressing into the ground. Arms are teed out to the side, palms up. Let your legs go over to one side, nice and controlled. And then up. Exhale, engage the core, over to the other side. Back up. Other side. One more each way. Nice, and we're gonna go into scorpion. On our bellies, arms are gonna be teeing out to the side. You are bringing that one knee out, reaching it over. Down, up, and to the other side. Love y'all good. Y'all might have actually heard that pop. Two more each way. Prone cobras here, hands are on the ground. Inhale and then exhale as you push yourself away from the ground. Back, inhale, exhale. Two more of these. One more. Nice, coming up into doing inchworms. 2 seconds. So we are tall, walking your hands out. Push up, drive one knee forward, up into a twist. Other side, push that knee back, other leg forward, up into a twist. Leg back, walk your hands all the way back up to standing. Two more of those. Walk all the way forward, push up, lunge, twist. Leg goes back, another lunge, another twist. Leg goes back, walk your hands back. So it gets me warmed up every time. Lastly, walking forward, push up, lunge, twist. Other side. Great, we're going into air squats. Pushing the hips back here and then. Two more. Nice. Seal jacks. Hands are going to be down, going here, and then opening up. So it's a here. Four. One, two. Nice. Now we're doing pineapple pickers. So, shoot my hips back, legs stay relatively locked, and I'm reaching forward, all the way up, to the center, all the way up, and then behind me, all the way up. Here we go for a count of 8 rounds. And we're on. One. Two more. Last ones. Nice. And last little bit of our active warm up is into that runner lunge. So loading up into this leg, into a reverse lunge, knee drive it up. It's like I almost stay down on that reverse lunge. So here we go in 4, 3, 2, 1, and we're on. Keep it moving fast. 10 seconds. 8, 3, 2, 1. Switch sides. Shake it out. Here we go. In 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and we're on in it. Stay on it. 3, 2, 1. Shake it out. Okay, this workout, we're going to do 6 minutes of cardio, 8 minutes of strength, cardio, and then a core finisher. Let me get our timer ready. It's all going to be time-based. And our first one is gonna be just 30-second rounds. No breaks, four exercises, three times through. We're going into jacks, then we're gonna go into scissor jacks, then we're gonna go into skaters, then we're gonna go into squat hops. Get a little air. Immediately back into that, three times through, nonstop, 30 seconds each. We are gonna start in five, four, three with jumping jacks, two, one, and we're on. Skaters are next in two, one, skaters. Keeping those hips back. Halfway. Final round of ollies. Five, four. In the skaters, and we're on. Halfway, we only got one more thing after this. Body push up. So first one, you're going to reach back. So it's like a deep reverse lunge where I'm reaching far back. My toe taps. This leg's trying to get parallel to the ground, loading up the glute, loading up the leg. Heel stays on the ground. I'd say about 80% of my weight, 80-85, stays in this leg. So I'm lightly touching back here, reaching my hands forward, driving it up, trying to balance, reaching and going back up. Round two of this, we're gonna go out to the side with it. So I'm shooting my hips back, reaching out to the side like that and coming up. Round three, we're gonna go into the curtsy of it. So curtsy it and back up, but it's a long reach curtsy. So it's not where I'm here, I'm reaching it back, long reach, and then driving it up. We have 40 seconds on one leg, 40 seconds on the other, and then the push-ups are gonna be breaking that up. So, here we go. 40, 10, 10. We're starting at 8 seconds. First round, we're going straight back. So here we go in 3, 2, and we're on. Reaching it back and driving it up. Reaching, that back foot can touch, but it's very light. It's like you're dipping your toe in water, like to test the water. So I'm barely tapping down. Long spine. Brace through this right here, and then exhale as you come up and knee drive. 3, 2, 1, other side. Here we go in 5, 3, 2, loading up this leg, reaching it back. Keep that weight in that front leg. Nice little tap back on the other side. Fifteen seconds. Three, two, one, push-ups. Here we go in 4, 3, 2, and you're on. Pace it out, 40 seconds is a long time. Five, 10 seconds. The side reach. So still shooting the hips back, just reaching straight out to the side. Hammer on. Keep it into this leg. Drive it up. Reaching. That reach forward allows me to really push back into my hips. Sides. Here we go in four, three, and reach. Shooting the hips back, shooting the hands forward. So from the side, I'm shooting my hips back, arms go forward to allow for that counterbalance. Awesome. Last round of this. This time we go into curtsies. Long reach curtsy. Here we go in three, two, one. Reach it across behind you. Trying to keep it shoulders and hips facing forward. Nice. Okay, next little bit. We're going back into kind of cardio. It will be 25 seconds of work, 5 seconds of rest. Everest mountain climbers. These are the ones I'm in that strong, tall plank. 1 foot comes all the way up as high as it can to my hand. Don't force it, but the idea is to get the foot close to the hand. But if your hip is only gonna go to here, that's as far as you should take it. Don't make it go anywhere. Don't force it to get up there, because you'll contort your body kind of weird. So starting out like this, and then switch with 25 seconds of that. Then mobile hops. These are the ones, kind of think like you're skiing down a mountain and you're going through the moguls. Feet are gonna start up this way. This way, like so. Then we're going into crab kicks, which will be lift the hips up, tap, tap, 25 seconds of that. We have 5 seconds of transitions and only enough time basically to get up and down off the floor quickly. So we're starting in 8 seconds. Those big climbers, 5, 4, 3, and we're on. Thank you. 10 seconds. And done. Crab kicks, last thing. Here we go in 2, 1. We're up. Keep the hips lifted.
So you can see on the wall, not me.
Okay. First one is going to be a squat chop. So I'm here, load up, fired over. I am only, from a side view, here, I'm only going to 90 degrees. I'm not over rotating through here, not wanting to get too much of a rotation that low back. So we're trying to focus on the rotation happening in the hips, firing up in the glutes. So again, I'm loading up like I'm gonna tie my shoe and then whipping it over like I'm gonna throw a sandbag or something over this way, straight 90 degrees out, pivot that back foot, strong glutes. You can add a weight here if you'd like. You can totally grab the ends of a dumbbell, or if you happen to have a medicine ball, great. Easily elbow, and then like that, okay? Right leg, 40 seconds. Left leg, 40, or left rotation, 40 seconds. Then we're going on the wall into this position right here. It's like you're gonna do a push-up. The lower you go and the more your feet walk out, the harder it is. So if you want it easier, you would just walk yourself up. We're doing a tricep extension. So your elbows will hit the wall. And then you will straighten yourself right back up. Nice strong plank. So do not let the hips stay. Don't let the hips stay out there like that. I don't want to bend into it. I want to contract my glutes, keep myself solid through the whole movement. So I'm moving up and down as a unit. 40 seconds in each place. Here we go. In 10. Exhale as you push away. Nice. Back to the squat chop. Weight optional. So if you have a weight, grab it. Three, two, and you're on. Halfway. Keep it going, we're gonna be close. Time, nice, one more round. Squat chop. Three, two, one. Push them back in those hips. Load the glutes. Strong, whip over. Don't let up now. Keep it strong all the way through. Four, three, two. Switch. Last time, other side. Here we go in three, two, one. Down, chop it over. All the way through. Load. Fire it over. 10 seconds. Final 10 here. Down to 5, 4, 3. And time. Last time on the wall. Final 40. Keep those elbows in. Keep arms parallel when you're down. We're on. Last 40 here. Thank you. Stay plank. Don't let yourself get saggy. Almost there. Done. Nice. Just a little bit left. I say a little bit. We have one more cardio round. We have cardio round. Oops, let me turn this thing back. Okay. We have this cardio round, and then we have a core round, and we're done. So, we have three different exercises in this next cardio round. We are gonna do, if I can find it, let's go 30-10. The exercises. It's a squat hop with a quick little twist at the top. So I'm here, up, down, up and the other way. So it's, okay? Then we are doing a pulsing squat. Whenever I say jump, you'll do a star jack. So it'll be here, pulse, 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 and then back into a pulsing squat. Okay? Well, it'll be like three or four star jacks within that segment. And then 30 seconds where we are jumping, back pedal, jumping forward, and back pedaling for 30 seconds. Okay? Here we go in 8 seconds. Start with that little squat hop twist at the top. 2, 1. Here, twist it. One more. Keep the pulse low. three, two, and jack it. Nice. Then we have that long jump back pedal. If you'd rather not jump, you can also run up and back pedal. Looks like this, or just run it up. Back pedal back, run it up. Either one. Nice, single leg bridge. Keep your knees in the same line together. Toes are up, heels in the ground. Knees stay in the same line. Don't get them way up over here. We're on. Drive just the glute up. Think about lengthening and contracting the glutes. Hips stay in the same line as if I put a delroy right across here, it would be parallel to the ground at all times. Switch. Toes up, drive the heel in. Knees are in the same line. We're on. 20 seconds here. Think about your glute. You're lengthening and contracting it. Done. Same side bicycle. Hands go behind the head. Legs will go out in the air. If you need to go into this position, great. As you want to make it more difficult, the legs go out. We're on the clock. Stay all in that one pattern. Break, other side. Three, two, one, done. Three, two, nice. One more round through all these. Start with the plank jack. Flipping over. Here we go in three, two, one. Halfway. Three, two, break. Side plank. Here we go in five. Two, and you're on. Eyes looking forward. Shoulders are stacked. Hips are stacked. Two, break. Here we go in three, two, one. Halfway. Break. Single leg bridge. Here we go in three, toes up, heel down. Break, switch. And we are on. Toes up, heel down, drive the heel in. Lengthen and contract that glute. Great, last thing, same side bicycle, hands behind the head. One pattern, we are on. Strong other leg, stay straight out. Three, two, one. Other side. 20 seconds and we're done. Awesome. Have a fantastic day.